Guys, welcome back to another vlog. I just finished off my last vlog and I'm in such a vloggy mood, but I'm getting ready for bed. I'm exhausted. 10:50 and I haven't done like a skincare routine in quite some time, and my skin has been looking, I don't even want to say it, because around this time of year my skin always goes crazy. Nothing more infuriating than trying everything and your skin not reacting to anything. I also figured out that I had fungal acne last year, and the only way you can clear that up is with Nizoral shampoo. So if you have a lot of little bumps on your forehead that you can't really like pop, they're not like pimples, it's probably fungal acne. And honestly, a few treatments with a dandruff, anti-dandruff shampoo, and those things cleared right up. The only product you need, in my opinion. I was just playing with the new makeup I got, and I did a little haul in the last video, and I think tomorrow I'll film myself like testing out all this stuff. And then in my Sephora recommendations video, I will let you guys know after I use a few times if I like it. So the makeup remover that I've been using, I stopped using makeup wipes because I ran out of them. And I was like, let me just use what I have. I've actually been really loving, my lips look crazy, I really overline them, this Tatcha Camellia Cleansing Oil. I wanna say 80% of my skincare is Tatcha, which is annoying because it's really expensive, but my skin just absolutely loves it. And then while my face is still wet, I take this cleanser, this Oxygen Cleanser from Skin Better Science. Love this cleanser. I foam it up in my hands, put it on my face, and then I leave it on my face for like a minute. I don't know why I have like dead flies all over my house. I don't know how flies are getting into my house. I don't see them alive, I just see them dead everywhere. Like, where are they coming from, and why do I never see them alive? Okay, I wanna give you an up close like update of my skin. So it's a little bit red right here because I was just like picking a little thing I had, but I swear my skin has not looked this clear in so long. The number one product, the number one skincare product on the planet, okay, Paula's Choice 2% BHA Liquid Exfoliate. Normally I put on a cotton pad, but I'm also out of those, and I just find like a towel works just fine. I really recommend using this on a cotton pad and not just putting it on your face. Nikki said this serum from The Ordinary is really good for your barrier. So we're gonna test this out. Ooh, that is quite shocking. I was not expecting a hot pink serum. When you're putting your serums and when you're putting all of this stuff on, it works best to like let it sit for a minute before you layer something else on top. That actually feels really nice, and look at that nice glow it leaves on your skin. I'm wondering how that would work under makeup. I want to quickly talk about fake tans for your face. I'm clearly not fake tanned at the moment. I did try putting this on my face, and it has potential to be good, and I probably will end up using it on my face because I don't want this to just sit and go bad. I started using this when I started dating Etan, which we've been dating for 2 years now, which is crazy. I was that girl who, like, the first few times you slept over, I slept with my makeup on. And here's your PSA. Crusty, slept on makeup never looks good. Like, a fresh face will always look better than like mascara dripping down. Like, what was I thinking? I don't know. When I finally took my makeup off, I was like, well, at least let me wake up with a nice tan. This was my only tanner I had in my house that didn't have a color guard, because I didn't want to go to bed looking like a freakazoid with color guards all over my face. He'd be like, why are you green? Like, what is going on? So I put this on and I applied it with a makeup brush like this, like contoured with it, and I swear, this is the best thing ever. I'm like just running out now. The whole tip of this is that when you're using something on your face, you want it to be the tanner that is clear. So whether it's a clear gel or a clear mousse, this one right here is also very good. This is the Face Tan Water. I like this one a lot as well. I've just been trying to finish this one, but it's the bottle that literally never ends. And I slug. I put my this on, and then I'll put my moisturizer on. You don't need a lot of it. It needs to be this healing ointment. I got this in the States. In Canada, I could only find the baby healing ointment, and that worked just as fine. Put it on your skin. You don't need to put that much. But when you wake up in the morning, you're gonna be hydrated. And then you can't forget about your lips. I'm gonna put this new caramel apple lip treatment on. Lip sleeping mask. Is there a color? I don't, oh yeah, look at that. Who wants that color? Who wants fluorescent orange lips? Anyways, if you aren't going to sleep looking like a big grease ball at least a few times a week, you are doing it wrong. This is like the only way I was able to fix my skin barrier from over exfoliating and overdoing a bunch of stuff. And then it's also really important to be sleeping on good sheets and a good pillowcase. I'll get more into that in the morning.
Morning, you guys. I look a little rough. I just got out of bed and got dressed because they're coming to deliver my shower door. What I always do whenever I have like a man coming to work on my house, not that this like would stop them in any way if they wanted to do something, but I always put a ring on, and like a noticeable ring, like a 4.7 carat oval. Nobody is missing this. Someone who built my house, I hope he's not watching this, keeps messaging me on Instagram, and it's just not the time or the place. Like, I didn't give you my information. It's like creepy. Like, do these men not realize that it's Leather? I'm trying to catch you. He plays this game where he wants me to catch him. So anyways, I slept amazingly. I just love sleeping in my own bed and sleeping at home. My bed is literally the comfiest bed in the world. That is a hill I'm willing to die on. I don't have my phone with me. So let's turn this alarm off. But yeah, that's just a little something I do. So that's another reason why our Lux rings are great. And just like, look how beautiful they are. I put on this little sweat set from Aritzia. I swear these pants make your butt look so good. I need a coffee more than I need air right now. I always feel like when I sleep more, I'm more exhausted. I got this jar at Zara Home, so I'm going to plop those in. Then my favorite coffee from them is Melozio. I have guests coming over today. My mom's best friend and I think some of her sons who we like grew up with. Mom requested I make one of my cheese plates and I do not feel like going to the grocery store. I also have a lot of stuff here, so I'm going to put one together from the stuff that I have here. The man was very nice. He came to drop off the door. I actually got a whole new shower. So he said to keep the parts and then, look at his little tush running off. He said to keep the parts and then if any other part of the shower explodes, I'll have a spare. Just need to get Leonard's breakfast served up. I've never seen a dog this picky.
It's my number one.
I can't get enough of this dog. I don't even know how people have children because I love him so much I could like die.
I personally have not owned that.
Okay.
Is that rule
me out? Okay, I just showered, put on my favorite outfit from Dynamite. This is from Zara, but these pants are from Dynamite. I have them in like three colors. They're the best loungewear ever. Especially when you, like for when you want to look put together and not so frumpy. But before we do that, I have to make my bed and I'm super excited because this portion of today's video is in collaboration with Brooke Linen, my favorite linens brand, my favorite towel brand, anything for my home, anything for my bedding or my towels, I get from Brooke Linen. So I've been a longtime fan, a longtime customer of Brooke Linen. When I moved, I knew that I wanted to make my house feel super luxurious. I wanted to feel like I was sleeping in a 5-star hotel bed every night. I don't have to wait until I go to a hotel or go experience these luxurious things. I wanted to experience them every day. And Brooke Linen, I promise you, when you test out their sheets, when you test out any of their products, you will not be able to go back to any other brand because they are truly the best. So Brooke Linen's prices are amazing and I do have a coupon code for you guys. But for me, as I get older, I just realize the importance of investing in good quality bedding, good quality towels, even though it is a little bit of an investment up front. The best part about investing a little bit into your bedding and all of your home items is that they will last you forever. So I have sheet sets from Brooke Linen from my old condo, from my old bed that I have given now to my boyfriend because because he has fallen in love with Brooklinen, and they feel just as good, if not softer, than they did when I first got them. You can see my bed is not made behind me, and I usually make my bed as soon as I wake up, and that is because it's the weekend, so it's change the sheet day. If you've been wanting to test out Brooklinen, if you've been wanting to upgrade your bedding, then I'm very excited to announce that you can get $20 off your orders of over $100 with the code TonySevdalis. And the best part is that that's not where the savings end. If you purchase the hardcore sheet bundle, which is what I recommend to everyone, because you get everything you need, you get the core sheet set, extra pillowcases, and a duvet cover, you will save 20% just by buying the set, which is everything you need to make a bed, you know? So you save 20% by purchasing the set, and then you also save $20 when you spend over $100 or more. So like I said, you get extra pillowcases, you get a duvet cover, and then you also get the core sheet set, which comes with a flat sheet, a fitted sheet, two pillowcases, and this will give you the best sleep of your life. And what's amazing is you can get the hardcore sheet bundle in any of their different product lines. So depending on what kind of sheets you like, they have something for you. First one that they have is the classic percale, and these sheets are perfect for hot sleepers. They're gonna keep you cool all night long. The second one is my favorite, the Luxe Sateen sheets, which have a slightly luminous finish. They are so buttery soft on your skin. They have a 480 thread count. They're a little bit more tightly woven than the classic percale, so they're a little bit warmer and a little bit heavier, but so comfortable. And the last one is their washed linen, which is really great for warm days or cool nights. The more you wash it, like, the softer it gets. You know what linen looks like. It's just absolutely beautiful. What's also amazing is that in the bundle, you don't have to get everything in the same color. So you can get the core sheet set in one color, the duvet cover in another. I just got everything in cream. The cream color is my favorite because it is like a super buttery, delicious kind of off-white. It's just perfect. So I'm gonna wash these, put these on my bed, and show you what it looks like. I quickly wanna show you the difference between the cream and the white. This is what the sheets look like on the bed before I put all of my little decor pillows. You can see the cream color is absolutely perfect. I literally just cannot wait to get into bed tonight. Alrighty, welcome to my bathroom. Welcome to my new shower door. For my foundation, I'm gonna go in with the Born This Way foundation. This has been a favorite of mine for a long time, and I just put it on with my fingers. This is definitely like a fuller coverage foundation, but when you apply with your fingers, it kind of blends out and looks a little bit more natural. Whenever I wanna look like flawless, that's the foundation I use. Not that that's my goal today, because I'm literally just staying home. I'm gonna try the Tower 28 concealer. I'm a little bit concerned about the color of this, so we'll have to see. Like, it looks dark. This is supposed to be light, not that dark, but it's not as brightening as I would like. Let's blend it out before it completely dries out. Oh, that does look really nice though. Okay, wait, maybe I was being dramatic. Oh, that blends so nicely. The issue I have with the Hell Slash concealer is that I just found it was very thick. I prefer a concealer like this, which is like super blendable and lightweight. I found that House Slap's one a little bit heavy. I'm gonna test out this nose contour brush. I'm a little bit scared of it, I'm not gonna lie. I think I'm gonna go in with the Patrick Ta contour. It's a little bit less extreme. And then I'm assuming you're supposed to blend it out with this. I'm still obsessed with this Huda Beauty setting powder. Like, nothing compares to it. Literally nothing compares to it. Makes you just look flawless. It makes your makeup last all day. Next, I'm gonna do eyes. I don't know if I wanna test out this Merit or test out this Patrick Ta Major Dimension palette. I feel like this might be a little bit more fun as I get my grime. I almost dropped that. I'm not gonna use any of the shimmers because it's a little dramatic for noon. I'm gonna go in with these tones for my crease. Oh, I didn't even do my eyebrow. Ooh, that is pigmented. And then I'm gonna take this lighter color here and put that here because that really lifts the eye. I feel like I should try something else, but I just don't wanna be that dramatic today. Let's test out these fun little eyeliners. So you get, oh, these are so cute. You get a white one, a black one, and then you get Anywhere Caffeine, which is like an amazing nude lip liner. You get a dark brown and you get a Wherever Walnut. So like all of their best sellers. I actually have this dark brown one. I keep it at Etan's house as like an emergency eyeliner. Now I wanna try this little squid palette. I'm intrigued by all of these colors. I swear these powders make you look like you have a filter on your skin. Okay, then for a blush, I'm gonna mix all three of these. Ooh. Isn't that pretty? Hello?
Hello.
Hi, baby. Okay, my makeup is done. I'm running super late, but I love how those hourglass powders made my skin. I'm getting my hair done this weekend. We're going to Toronto, and I'm getting my hair done. I haven't done it since June, the beginning of June. I thought that maybe we can test out, like, on these extensions, like, a fun haircut. No turning back now. Oh, that actually looks way better. Wait, that looks so much better. It's not short, it just looks a lot fuller. I know that was probably like a very anticlimactic chop because I didn't chop it that short. Whenever I'm trying to do like a blowout look with my hair with the Dyson, I always think it looks most blowouty when you curl it towards your face. So I know you're always told like, away from your face, away from your face. But when you want that blowout look, you want it towards your face. And I also keep it very at the ends. Okay, so then for the front pieces, I do it with this attachment because if not, they get too curly and they just look weird. Honestly, I just wrap it around and pull, and then I keep twisting it and pulling it and twisting it and pulling it. First day hair is never my ideal hair, but that's basically how I do my blowout look. I don't know why my nose is so itchy. I'm listening to an audiobook from Odette Stone. I always get asked about which audiobooks I love. I'm Audible's number one fan. Number one fan. I swear no one listens to Audible more than me. I listened to them so much at one point that I got kicked off. Not kicked off, but they banned me from buying more credits to buy more books. Anyways, I found a new author I love, Odette Stone. I love when romance books are like a little bit unrealistic. Like an NHL player falls in love with a homeless woman, like that's my cup of tea, okay? And I always get asked about my book recommendations, and I have a Goodreads account if you want to follow me on there. I don't like write reviews, but I keep a list of all the books that I've read, and then I also rate them. And then I started listening to her other series, My Brother's Fiance. My Fiance's Brother, what is it? Oh my gosh, is that book ever terrible? But I'm so in it now that I have to finish it. So I finished the first one and then I was like, well, I need to know what happened. So I'm on the second one now. Do not recommend. I mean, it's okay. It's still better than like People We Meet on Vacation. That was such a bad book. Emily Henry is like not my kind of romance author. You know what I got? I got this in the States the last time I was there. Good Culture Probiotic Sour Cream in a Bag. Why don't we have sour cream in a bag here? It is so useful. I hope you guys really appreciate all of the amazing things you have, like sour cream in a bag. That is a luxury that us Canadians just don't have, and it's like such a little thing. There's also a weird smell going on in my pantry that I probably should get to the bottom of, but I'm gonna save that for another day because I just don't feel like tackling this mess at the moment. I could smell it's probably, I think it's like an onion that's going bad. You know, those onions, they'll get ya. I tried this creamer today, the Chobani Peppermint Mocha. This is another thing from the States that we don't have here. We don't have Chobani creamer. I don't know, I call it Chobani, but is it Chobani? I have no clue. My favorite snack recently has been cottage cheese. This is the best brand, also only available in the US. So whenever I go there to the US probably, I should go once a month, honestly, just to do my groceries. Like that's how much
better it is and also way more affordable. The texture of cottage cheese really used to freak me out because it is quite alarming, but it kind of tastes like burrata, if you've ever had that. And burrata, as you know, is like a harder cheese on the outside and inside is kind of liquidy. So in my brain, I'm just like, this is as if I chopped up a burrata. And then it doesn't gross me out anymore. Crazy how my mind works. Just take a little bit of this. And then I have this truffle balsamic glaze and I just go on and I glaze it up. And then a very important part is adding a little bit of salt. I like a flaky salt. And then I just eat this as a dip with a chip. Oh my gosh, you guys, I think I've just created the most perfect creamy recipe on the planet. So this is actually the first time I made a creamy since the incident with the protein shake back in June, where I projectile vomited after I drank a protein shake. So I was a little thrown off with the chocolate protein, but when I was at Walmart the other day, I picked up this chocolate milk, which isn't their protein shake, it's just the chocolate milk. Best chocolate milk on the planet. I froze that. And then, okay, we need to whip it up again. I wanted a peppermint kind of ice cream because I'm going to be making a brownie. And I wanted a peppermint fudge ice cream for my brownie. I'm so excited, I can't even form thoughts in my brain. I tasted it, it is so good. I'm gonna whip that up again and make my brownie. I get these little cups when I go to the States, I swear everything I eat is from the States. I can't finish a full one, so I'll just like, normally I'll scoop some out into a little cup and then make a little one. I'm gonna make that quickly, re-spin it, and then we'll reconvene in a second. Okay. I actually made the brownie with some of the chocolate milk instead of water. It needs another second. Okay, brownie's done. It's not like fully done, but I don't want it to burn. Look at this ice cream. Look at this ice cream. All this is this chocolate milk and then a little splash of this creamer. I think you're playing a trick on me. You can either mix the brownie in, but I'm just gonna dump the ice cream right on top. That should be illegal. And you can add more protein to your ice cream. I'm just like easing back into it.
Oh my gosh.
Back in 2020, I literally had to withdraw from sodium. It was not a fun time in my life. I sound like I'm joking, but my doctor literally was like, you need to stop eating so much sodium. And I was like, okay, like I'm just gonna cut out the sodium because I would put salt on everything. I would ask for salt all the time at restaurants. I would eat copious amounts of cheese, which has so much sodium. Like literally I could not get enough sodium. I thought that like, I would just cut down on sodium and like things would be a little bit more bland, but I would get over it. No, I literally went through withdrawals of sodium, like headaches, nausea. All I could think about was sodium. It was the weirdest thing. All I craved was sodium. Didn't last that long, but that was the weirdest thing. It's crazy that your body can get addicted to anything. Anyways, I don't know where I was going with that situation. How did I get on a sodium addiction? I can't remember, but I'm thoroughly satisfied. That was great. Hey guys, okay, so I just finished filming a quick two reels for Instagram. I have an audience over here. She won't leave me alone. but I got some things in from Dynamite I thought I would show you. This is actually an outfit, not from Dynamite, but this is, I did a bougie versus budget reel. So this is the bougie version. And then I styled the budget version on Instagram. I think I really enjoy doing that. So I'm gonna try to do that more often. But I got some things in from Dynamite I want to show you. I got 3 new coats in that I think you're going to love. So first one I want to talk about is this one. So last year, actually exactly a year ago, when we went to Toronto to get my hair done, our hair done last time, I got this coat and it's from Aritzia. This was like $500. What's great about this one though, I have to say, is that it's made for really cold weather. It's made to be really warm. So it has this nice pattern. I fell in love with this coat, but it is so expensive. So when I saw this one from Dynamite, which is a little bit lighter, but has that same kind of pattern, I knew I had to test it out for you guys. And this is how I can justify myself having way too many things, because while they are very similar in my mind, they're like completely different coats, but they still get the same job done. Like, they're still very beautiful. They still have the pattern on. This one just has a little bit more movement to it, but also has more structure in the shoulder pad area, because the Aritzia one is the slouch coat, and they actually have this in like regular black, regular solid print. You can tell this one's like very substantial, but it doesn't have the same shoulder pads. See, I would go with the more affordable one because there's not that much of a difference. I also saw Zara had a good dupe for that. This one is, I think, my favorite one. I love a good leather coat. I love leather and I love brown leather. And this one is just the most perfect. It even looks good with black.
Slay.
It is so cute. I styled it with jeans, but it looks so cute with an all black outfit. Everyone says don't put brown and black together. Don't put brown and black together, but it has to be one of my favorite combos. I've actually stopped buying as much fuzzy things recently just because I feel like I was going a little bit overboard, but this is such a cute fuzzy little bomber, like a little snow bunny. This is gonna be so perfect for when I, like, even though this is probably never gonna happen, but I can picture myself going like up to a chalet and going skiing, although I am a good skier. I discovered that last year. Nikki and I are gonna go skiing this year.
Not tubing.
Not tubing. Tubing less than skiing.
Because?
Nikki tore her ACL.
MCL.
Her MCL. Tubing. The moment I left, everything went downhill from that tubing. And then that's the night that I fried off all my hair.
I went to Toronto with my leg.
Oh, that was a rough time. I do picture myself with like some cute earmuffs up at the chalet. I don't know when I'll get there, but that's the vision. Remember when I had a phase where everything I got was for brunch? Like, ask me how many times I've been to brunch. 0 times. But then I also got some clothes for the holidays. Look at this little top. Like, this with a pair of like black pants or even like a black little skirt. This was my favorite thing ever. Was this your favorite thing too out of the haul?
It looks so good on you.
Thank you, Nikki. It is a long leather maxi skirt, but it is so flattering. It goes real long. I just folded it in. And then I paired it with this off-the-shoulder sweater. The only gripe I have with this is that it's not like sewn down off the shoulder. Like, this one is off the shoulder, but it like it stays off the shoulder. This one kind of rolls up. I got a comment on TikTok saying that this sweater was outdated.
You did.
And like, that comment hurt more than any of the other comments, because I truly love these off the shoulder sweaters. And you know what? They are, but I also just love them. And fashion goes in cycles, okay? So it is outdated, but it's coming back. All right, so we just ate lunch and then we filmed another reel. And now we're gonna go through all of my winter jackets and I'm gonna be selling a lot of them. I just do not need that many jackets. And also I've gotten a few new ones this year, so I wanted to get rid of them. I have coats everywhere. I have coats in here. I have coats downstairs. I have coats in my basement.
It's really scary.
I'm terrified. So I think we're gonna bring them all downstairs and then we can go through them.
You wanna bring all these downstairs?
Yeah.
There's not that many.
I'm more in the basement too.
Yeah, in the basement.
Welcome to my closet, my coat closet. Okay, so I'm gonna go through I'm gonna go through them all quickly. If you wanna see my full coat collection video, you can check out this video I did last year. I was actually wearing the same outfit, not planned. Those are like my fall coat essentials. But in this video, in this vlog, I'm gonna go through the ones that I'm selling. And if any of them intrigue you, DM me. This is a jacket from Dish that I'm going to sell, even though I love the color of it, just because the length, I've like never worn it. So why am I gonna keep it? This is a cropped little jacket from Zara. Never worn it. I love that jacket, but on me, it's just not the kind of thing that I'm going to wear. Oh, it's cute. It's really cute.
Smash.
It's a jacket I got off some random website because I fell in love with the Nicole Benisti coats, and I have a few of them here gifted to me. So yeah, this is not like a real Nicole Benisti coat, but it's really cute, and I will definitely be keeping this. I think it was like $150. The only thing is that the sleeve, am I flashing you?
No.
The sleeves
are short.
But like, how cute is that? Okay, this is a fleece. Oh, I also forgot I had this.
It's from Aritzia?
Yeah, super cute. Love it.
You had a phase with those last year.
You know why? Because at my meetup at Bumbaloni, this beautiful girl was wearing this in brown. So I immediately went and bought it, but in black for some reason. Remember the girl with the ponytail?
Her name is Emily, and she will be watching.
Princess Polly cropped puffer.
You have the black Dish one. You don't wear this.
I was about to put it in the giveaway pile. Like a lightweight
classic puffer. I've just never seen you wear that before.
I actually wore this the day I found out my papa passed away. It's the only memory I have of this coat, but for some reason like I wear it at least once a season. Ooh, this one, I cannot wait to wear this. This is the Lamarck coat jacket. This again, when I went to Nicole Benisti, I was like trying to find more affordable ones. And this is, while it's still expensive, it is definitely more affordable. Ooh.
And it's leather.
It's leather, and it has like the puffy in the back. Can they see?
Mm-hmm.
And then the shirling, what I love about it is it's not like so stark white. I feel less like Santa Claus and more like
Mrs. Claus.
Yeah. Nikki, is this my most worn jacket or is it my most worn jacket?
The black one especially.
Reason why I love a cropped jacket like this and why I realize why I love this one so much is that it goes to the perfect length. You kind of want everything to meet at the smallest part of your waist. You don't want it to come down longer. It's gonna make your legs look shorter. I should tell Dish to make them again.
She really has had them for 2 years and she wears them every day.
Every day. As if I have a say over what Dish makes. This is a true Nicole Benisti coat. This weighs, I'm not kidding you, 20 pounds. And the issue, this is the real deal with what happened. I had purchased this style coat, also from Nicole Benisti. This is the one they had gifted me. But I had purchased it in this colorway. And then when I went to go, I literally ordered it. And then it didn't ship. And this is like a $3,000 coat. I ordered it at nighttime, delusional, like Nikki should revoke access to my PayPal at nighttime. So I ordered this coat, but in that style, it was a whole big thing, you guys. I reached out to them because I was just never getting my coat. Then they were like, why don't you come to the showroom? We'll have your coat ready. And I was like, okay, anything to get my coat at this point. And then when we got there, like the fur was just ugly. Like it was ugly, Nikki.
It just was like ball. It felt cheapy. Like yeah. It looked like that Revolve coat. No, the one next to
this.
It. That was
yes.
Inside the coat.
But then I saw this coat and it looked how it should be. It was just like the fur on that specific coat was so ugly. And so I was standing there and I was like, I wasn't going to say anything, but then I was like, okay, wait, this is like a $3,000 coat. I was like, honestly, I just have to say this is really ugly. Like, I don't want this coat. Rather a refund. And honestly, like, you should tell them that, like, they shouldn't even be selling this because it's not what the pictures look like. And so she was like, okay, well, would you rather exchange it for this coat?
It is really pretty.
It's really pretty, but I prefer the style of the other coats. Everything worked out, but I was literally like, you should not sell this coat because it's a lie. Like, you see how soft this fur looks? It literally looked, Nikki's right, it looks like this, but this looks nicer. Actual coats, like the quality is really good and it'll keep you very warm in the cold winter months. This one is from
Shein.
It's like a quilted coat. It's very nice, I have to say, but should I sell it? Am I ever gonna wear it?
Have you worn it?
No. A lot of things I love, but for some reason I find them impossible to style.
I think you should get rid of it.
I'm gonna get rid of it. The thing about this is, Nikki, the thing about this is I find it so hard to style this color. I've had it for a full winter and I never wore it out of my house one time.
It's a little bit
pimpy.
I was gonna say pimpy.
It's a little pimpy.
It looks like you're gonna.
Melanie loves this coat.
So give it to her.
Ooh, it's pimpy. But it's cute! This is a vest.
I remember when you got this.
Why did I get this? I'm never gonna wear this. Why did I get this? I think I saw one person wearing a vest and then I bought 12 vests.
She has fixation problems.
Oh wait, I got this one too. This one's a little scarier.
Where's that one from? Like Count Dracula. Look at the collar.
If I get in a vest mood, then I have to buy another one. I'm gonna get rid of this one and keep this. This aloe cropped little jacket.
When did you get that?
I got this a long time ago. So I actually got this jacket and it's in pink velvet.
It's for sale at the office.
It's for sale. I wore it so much. I loved that jacket. And so I wore it so much I got the black one, but I don't know, the black one didn't do it for me as much as the pink velvet.
It's a bit flat.
The pink velvet one was cute.
The pink velvet one was like very puffy.
Okay, it all comes back to Nicole Macy. So I was finding dupes for you guys for Nicole Benisti coats. And this one is a really cute one. However, like I said, I just have so many coats. I never reached for this one. It literally still has a tag on it, even though it's cute. I did get yelled at for posting about this coat, but I'm obviously gonna post a dupe. Like, let's be real. So while I do love this one, I know I'm not gonna wear it, so I'm gonna get rid of it. This one I'm not even trying on. I have literally never worn it. This is Nikki's like favorite jacket. This is a long coat from Misguided. I'm gonna sell it because I have a lot of other long coats. This is a Zara jacket I got such a long time ago. I wore it so much. I had it in nude and black. That's kind of cute.
It is cute.
But do I look like a beanbag chair?
No. But I don't know if you're gonna wear it, but it's
really
cute.
Comfy. Like to walk Leonard. I told you I had it in nude as well. And knowing myself, I have more somewhere else, but this is my big pile of jackets. So if you want any of them, then DM me or stop by our office and I'll have them there. Now Nikki has requested some tea. What kind of tea do you want?
Oh, I don't know. Let's look in the fun tea drawer.
Okay. We were having our tea and relaxing, and then Nikki came up with this great plan.
We are making tomato soup and grilled cheese.
Leonard, are you going to have some tomato soup? But Leonard's actually British, so he's having tomato soup.
And crumpets. You could just stare at him all day.
I really could.
He looks like a little white Arctic fox.
Oh, hello. The other day I was putting something, a jacket on him, and he bit me. Ready for bed. Okay, so we just got home from the grocery store. My kitchen's a little bit of a mess, but we'll clean that after. The first step we're gonna do is wash all of our tomatoes. We're kind of blending two recipes together and just, you know, going on what we think would taste good. So we're gonna wash our tomatoes. Would you like to rinse these for me, please?
Sure.
As I prep the rest. So I'm going to cut these tomatoes in half just so all the juices can get out of there. What makes tomatoes so difficult to cut?
The skin, I think.
How is a tomato skin stronger than a knife? Thank you, chef.
You're welcome, chef. She put 4 cloves and he put 2 garlic heads.
We should do 1 more onion. I'm gonna drizzle some olive oil on there. I got these at Target. Aren't they cute? This is what it looks like. So we're gonna pop this in. I burnt the croutons.
They're still good.
But this is how it's doing. I still don't think it's ready, Nikki.
Well, it's not ready. It's gonna cook for 25 more minutes.
But I think we shouldn't, I don't know if we should add the sauce into this pot. My gut is telling me no. Okay, so this looks so much better. I think now we can add in the chicken stock and the vegetable stock and the cream. So how many?
4.
4 cups.
One.
I feel like that's a whole carton.
How much cream?
About a cup.
Perfect. Beautiful. Mm. So now we're gonna let this all cook together. I wanna say maybe like 20 minutes. And then we're gonna blend it all up together.
Is this the best way to do this? Probably not, but I'm scared of filling half of it when I'm transferring it. Hot, I don't know where the top thing is, so I'm gonna put this here.
Coming along, we have our grilled cheeses in. We have a smoked cheese and a mozzarella in there. We're gonna cook them low and slow so it gets all melty. This is the final product. My grilled cheese got a little burnt. I don't know how, I put it really low and it still got burnt with the soup, and just look at how divine that looks.
It is Thursday today. I haven't vlogged in a few days. I've been so busy at the office getting everything organized. We're leaving on our little trip to Toronto, so we're gonna be open on Thursday instead, which is today. And I was getting all of the clothes. I brought a lot of the jackets from that you just saw to the office. And I was pricing them and getting them all ready for today. And then I was also going through all of the watches, which have very minor defects on them, because we don't sell watches obviously with defects on them, but the defects are like little tiny hair, like hairline scratches on the side of the face, or like maybe one of the pins. You can't like remove one of the pins, but unless you're removing every single pin in the watch to size your wrist, which some people do, you won't notice it. So I put those together, and those are some of them are $75 Canadian, which is more than half off. That's like probably in this conversion, in this economy, probably $2 American. Yeah, so if you've been wanting to a watch, to test out the watch, or just want another one for a great price, then we have those available. And then also today I'm gonna bring a ton of like PR that I got sent. I just created a box of like stuff that I either have tried, it's been sent to me again, or doesn't necessarily interest me and I know someone else would like to use it more. So Max sent me all of these, which I'm so appreciative of, okay? This is not me complaining. They sent me all of their new, I don't know if these are new, but they're these lipsticks, Locked Kiss 24-hour lipsticks. And out of all of these ones, these are the only colors that really intrigued me. So I'm gonna bring all of these, and then when you come and shop in store, you can pick a little free makeup product. I'm gonna go get ready quickly and then head to the office. Right, so I just finished getting ready for work. I'm wearing this brown, oh, I forgot my nipple stickers. Maybe my hair will cover it. I'm wearing this brown turtleneck with these brown pants from Aritzia, my Fendi sneakers, large rain earrings, two-tone prestige watch. I don't know why I'm feeling so exhausted today. And then I've been trying, I didn't really remember this morning, but I heard apparently if you drink 30 grams of protein within 30 minutes of waking up, you're like set. It solves all your problems. So I have a little protein shake. First time I'm drinking a protein shake since the incident. I'm just gonna take it nice and slow because I do not want a repeat of last time. I meant to vlog when I got to the office, but it has been absolutely crazy. This is the first time I'm sitting down to edit all day, and it's 2:15 and we opened at 11, and I've had the best day, truly the best day. I got to meet so many of you. So many of you are so, well, all of you are so sweet. You get to shop the clothes and shop the watches. I don't know why we didn't do this sooner. It honestly makes my whole week. So now I'm just sitting in my office, which is not complete yet. Changed how my office was oriented. So I used to be sitting this way because I wanted to look out the window, but now I like sitting this way so that when you walk in, I'm like behind the desk. I don't know, it feels like more official, you know? This is not my office, like it's our office, but I'm pretty much the one who sits here the most, like editing the pictures and editing stuff. Allie's mostly like, well, she's primarily in the like packing room, and then Nikki just floats around, does what she needs to do. This is really the next room that I have to tackle. But anyways, I think I'm gonna close off the vlog here because I
I'm in the middle of editing this vlog, so I want to just close it off. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed it. I will make sure to leave all of the Brooklinen stuff and everything linked down below, along with anything else that I mentioned. Don't forget to subscribe for new videos every single week. I love you so much, and I'll see you guys back here next time.